practiced the whole time. I probably could have had more practice. They did great. I appreciate it. Today we're going to start three different types of meetings that will involve all of you at least one of those meetings. We're going to, after the service, start those of you that had that invitation. We're going to continue with the who are we and why are we here. We're going to go to the next step and say, you know, why are we here and how can we grow together? So we're going to start that process today. And if you haven't had your invitation yet, it will be forthcoming. It will be at the end of August, between how God thinks and how we think. So how to connect with Him. We got the old cans there with the rope to connect. I'd like to start out with this story. In honor of Aaron, because he was on the cruise ship. On February 10, 2013, a fire broke out in the engine room of a Carnival cruise ship. It was called the Triumph. I don't think it was very triumphant that day. The fire knocked out the ship's power, leaving the vessel drifting in the Gulf of Mexico. There were more than 4,200 passengers and crew left sitting out in the Gulf. The lost power made it impossible to operate the toilets, to keep cool in the unshaded waters of the Gulf of Mexico, and to preserve and cook all the perishable food on board. Passengers reported long lines for food, shortages of fresh water, illnesses, and widespread boredom. Many passengers slept in hallways or outside to escape the odors and the heat. CNN dubbed the Triumph the cruise ship from hell. The ship finally ported safely in Mobile, Alabama on February 14th, so it was over 4 days. News crews riding in helicopters followed the ship and watched passengers beg for help. The ship's loss of power wasn't just a tragedy for the passengers. Carnival expected to lose hundreds of millions of dollars due to this incident. Apparently, Carnival learned their lesson. So in June 2013, Triumph set sail once again, but this time it was outfitted with new emergency power capabilities. And the key line is, Carnival knows that when the power goes out, the party is over. When the power goes out, the party is over. When our connection with God, who is the power of our life, goes out, the party is over. That's what prayer is. Go online, go to YouTube, look at prayer. So what is prayer? They ask these little kids and they're folding their hands. Why are you folding your hands? It's just what we do, it's what they've been taught to. And what else do you do? Oh, we close our eyes. What is prayer? It's not some special thing we do in a monastery. It's a connection with God. Okay, God's in the seat. We're over here. Prayer is this line right here. If you concentrate on the line, it's going to be very difficult. Why got to pray? That's not how you do it. If I want to connect with my wife, I need to concentrate on my wife, not on communication skills. Or I gotta just have better relational qualities about me. We just need to do this or do that. I need to concentrate on Benita if I want a relationship with Benita. I gotta get to know her. I gotta see how she ticks. I gotta be interested in her. Then the line takes care of itself. Don't concentrate on prayer. Concentrate on God. Concentrate on getting to know God. That sort of puts this mysteriousness of prayer kind of away. It's about connecting with God. And some of the difficulty is, we're going to get into it. There's difficulties in connecting with God. But before we do that, let's go ahead. Let's get in little groups. To you, what is prayer? Let's talk about it. To you, what is prayer?